So there's a couple of things that motivated me to want to bake a cake on a barbecue. First was that baking seems to be hugely popular right now. But primarily, really my real reason for wanting to do it was sometimes when you have a barbecue, you want to have something for pudding. And really everybody loves cake, and if you don't eat it, it keeps really well and you can eat it for your lunch all week, which is exactly what I like to do. So today I'm going to do exactly that. I'm cooking some pork for dinner, so don't take too much notice of this placing of the pork on the barbecue bit if you're only going to make a cake. And you would place your cake mix just where I've placed that pork now, and then you'll follow the instructions from when you put the lid on later. So I need a bit more extra cooking space in my barbecue, and I'm going to use my barbecue stacker to create exactly that space I need. I'm going to cook a sponge cake, and I've already made the mix up inside. I'm not going to go into the details of that, but you can cook any cake you like, but this is a chocolate sponge cake. And I'm going to place it just in the centre of the barbecue here. Hot coals in the barbecue, all ready to go. Cake mix in, and I'm going to put the lid on. My cake wanted, according to the recipe, to be cooked at 180°C, which is just over 350 Fahrenheit. So, you know, let's not split hairs here. We're pretty well close enough. Putting the hot charcoal in, as I did straight from the chimney, means that my cooking temperature is going to be hotter than if I leave it to later in the cook. So I've given it the 15 minutes or so that the instruction recipe told me to cook this cake for, but it's not ready yet. And if you're not monitoring that cooking temperature, then you may have to cook your cake possibly a little bit less time if it's really scorching hot in the barbecue, but you may have to cook it a little bit longer. So the recipe for my cake here said cook for up to 20 minutes, but I've actually cooked this for 25 minutes. So I'm really pleased with the result I've had from cooking this cake on a barbecue. I'm just going to do my arty bit and take it out of the cooking dish, and I'm going to dress it with a little bit of cocoa. I really think you could cook any cake. At the end of the day, a barbecue is a lot like an oven, so as long as you consider the cooking temperature versus the time that the cake or pudding needs to cook, then adjust according to that, you're really not going to have any problems. So it would have been fun maybe to make two sponge cakes and make a Victoria sponge cake, for example. You'll simply have to trust me that there's no smoky taste to this cake. It actually is really rather delicious, and it was quite good fun to make. I think you could have a lot of fun trying it yourself if you are somebody who likes to bake and maybe not a big barbecue person. Why not give it a go? I've seen them on TV just making the plate look nice, so I thought I'd do that. And maybe I'm not going to win any awards at the Village Cake Show, but you know what? I enjoyed it. You'll have to believe me that everybody enjoyed eating it. And I hope it's inspired you to have a go too. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.